Good morning. Today I'm going to do an AK dungeon streamer. It's a very simple pattern. It's a jointed one, articulated or tandem, whatever you want to call it. Years ago they used to call them tandems. I'm using extra large fish joints. These are come in various sizes. I'm using the extra large because I'm going to use a size 2 hook, 4X long, yellow flat wax nylon thread, North Kraken Dubber, AK dubbing, in dungeon olive, and then I'm going to use the big bopper dubbing in dungeon olive as well for the head. Let's put the fish joint in this extra large. I'm going to go like this. What I want to do is when these big large ones, I go to thread underneath the point, and I also do this. I want to go, this locks it on top of itself. Otherwise it can flip over with a lot of pressure from thread. So I'm going to go do this. I want to layer this nice and thorough. I'm going to use bug legs. You can see how it rolled over. There we go. I'm going to lock it in. There. Okay. I'm going to use some bug legs on this. Since it's an olive color, let's use, oh, what's a good color? We're going to use two. We're going to use regular olive, yellow, and I think I'll use some radioactive. This gives it a nice UV appearance to it. Since I'm going to use three of them, I'm going to take four of each. This is like similar to doing the legs on the feet on the frog. We're going to use four of these. Let's get these out of here. Okay. One set. I'm going to put them on my leg because I want to keep them, the tips even. Four of these. I like to lay them across my leg. That makes them, I don't have to worry about picking them up. They're easy to pick up at that time. Okay. Right here. I'm going to put this right here above the point back. I'm going to tie it. There. Just like this. Measure it. Cut. Now it splays out because it's along the side of the joint. Keeps that tail splayed out so they're on top. It also covers the joint a little bit. Alright. Move my thread right about there. Now I'm going to start making the body of the fly. I'm going to be using Northern Kraken or NK dubbing the dungeon olive because this is an olive color pattern. Alright. I don't want huge amounts of it. I want this fairly slender, but I want to be able to cover things. But right here along the side, I don't really need it on the bottom much because you want to have room for the gap later so you get used to doing it here on this. Okay, right there on this side, pull it back, bump it, okay, I'm going to go up here, I'm going to, right above this, I'm going to make a layer of thread. Okay, now I'm going to take some bug legs, I'm going to get some legs coming out of here, and I think on this one I'm going to do a little bit of contrast. We're going to do say black, yellow, and olive. I'm going to do, no, I think I'll do, I'm going to just do olive and yellow. So I'm going to do two each, lay them across my leg again, okay, all right, and what I'm going to do with this, try to even them up, right in front of this point, I'm going to put it in, my thread's back here. I'll hold it like this along the side. I'll lock it in. I'm gonna measure the legs, whatever length you want, cut. I'm gonna go back up here and tie it off. If you're doing a bunch of these, you might want to do a lot of these jointed ones beforehand. I'm gonna take my UV glue. I want to make sure I cover everything. Just make sure the fish's teeth doesn't destroy it. Take my light up on top. With this solar ease, which is nice stuff, take 10, 15 seconds. I'm going to do it on this side, underneath a little bit. And that should do it. So I'm going to get ready. I have to put a piece of wire to make the joint swivel. So I cut. This is American fishing wire. And it's 45-pound test, nylon coated strand of stainless steel wire for leaders and trolling. I've got about 1,000 feet of this. Nice stuff. I really like to use it. Years ago, I used it on a tandem trolling streamers from back east. I'm going to take this in my hand. I want to measure the ends close. Hold them, and I want to bend that, squeeze that so it bends a little bit. Not tight, close enough. You can put this in this right now. Put this in and put this aside. Now I'll take my big hook, put it right in there. Okay, I'm going to layer this whole shank, and it takes a little time because it's a length. It's a big hook. I'm going to do it size 4, use it large fish joints. Size 6, use a medium. Size 8, use a small, and so forth. Matches up pretty good, right to the bend, up again. Okay, that should do it. What I do is I'm going to take my fish joint with the leader or the swivel I have. I'm going to put there's the bend or the end of the hook. That's where I want the end of my fish joint to be, roughly. I'm going to measure up here. I don't want it too far up, so I'm going to cut it. Nice pair of pliers in the hardware store. Do I have it right? Yep, I like it. So I'm going to take my super glue. Let me see if I can coat this. Just a little coating, not much. Alright, so I'm going to take at the end. I'm pinching it back here. If I pinch it, I can pinch them together, and when I do that, it stays right on top. You can go back. And it's right where I want it. So I'm going to go back and forth with this, tying it down tight. This crisscrossing of the thread helps hold it, as well as the super glue. Years ago, that's how you locked in those trolling streamers, like Grey Ghost, Supervisor 9-3s. May God smelt those. You just crisscross the thread. Okay. I've got that. Now I'm going to start making the body like I did here. I'm going to put the thread right there. I mean, exactly, back that up a little bit. Again. The Kraken, and Northern Kraken dubbing. Right, I'm going to take, I don't need, I want it too thick. Here, I want to be able to cover over here. Right on there. Take a little bit more. You can make it thick if you want. But I want to be able to make sure that enough of the gap, the hook, the fish will take, hold. Right there. Pull it, I'm pulling it around, I'm pulling it up and on the sides. I don't want it underneath it very much. You need room in that gap for the take a bite on the fish. Okay, move it up, do another batch. Okay, right there. This Northern Kraken dubbing has You know, it's like the Kraken bait material. It's about an inch and a half long, roughly. And there is fine starburst fibers in there as well. And then I put some Northern Lights in there for the tinsel. You can see the tinsel's in there, larger tinsel. It's the same as adding tinsel. It's already included. All right, another batch right here. I'm going to pull that up and along the sides, not on the bottom. Okay, bump it. Going to go up and see, where do I want to put my eyes? I think I put them right there. These are, I'm going to be using, are some big eyes. Take my tweezers. I think I will use yellow on here. These are big. Extra large dumbbell eyes with 8mm fish eyes. So I'm going to put it right there. A little bit of super glue. Top and the bottom. I'm going to put these on the bottom. Right there. Crisscross it. Figure eight. Okay. A little tighter, then go back here. What I'm going to do here, I'm going to put some legs. I'm going to use, that's my little mutt. I'm going to use, let's see what I've got here. I think I'll add a little bit of, how about we do olive, red, and radioactive. What I'm going to do, I'm going to put more legs on this. I'm going to take two of each. It's a little bit of red so it looks like it's bleeding, or a little bit of color contrast has helped. What did I do with my red? Okay, there's my red. There's my red. Two of that. Alright, we're gonna same thing again. What I'm gonna do with this, medium, wrap it around, hold it alongside, tie it down like this. What this does, keeps it on the side. Look at it, what length you want, cut it. Here you go. And I'm going to do a little bit of body just in front of that, just a little bit. Not too much. Right here. Okay, pull it back, lock it in. Okay, I want a smooth base here. Okay, now I'm going to take the big bopper in a dungeon olive. This is in place of deer hair. That's all it is. It has a nice model look. I like the color combinations, I like the legs in it. You can trim it and use it just like deer hair. So I'm going to take a nice, fairly heavy batch of it. Because you want a collar too. Put along this side. Let it go down. I'm going to take another heavy batch. I should say too heavy, but heavy enough. On this side. And then I want some on top. We're going to trim this, so I need something up there. Right there. Now, if you think you need a little bit more, you can put just a little bit in front of that on the side, just a little bit. You don't want too much, because I'll show you what we need to do next. the other side. There we go. Okay, what we're gonna do, take some more of this. We're gonna put this right on top. I'm gonna crisscross from the front of this, of the eye to the back. Just one. Hold it. Underneath, the same thing. I'm gonna go in front. All right, now I'm gonna put the last batch, fairly thick. Pretend you're using deer here. Right here, let it spin. That's all I let do. A little bit more on this side, let it spin if you want. Fluff it up, move my thread in front. All right, a few wraps behind the eye, tie it off. Pull it tight. I'm gonna use my UV glue. Lock it. Okay. Now, I'm going to move this out of the way. I'm going to trim it right here. Hold the hook right here, okay? Trim the flat, just above the eye, I should say. Blow it out of the way, pick it up, find the point, find the eye, and go straight up at an angle. Don't cut all the collar off. Go on the side a little bit. Blow it. Now I'm going to find my eye. My eye is right here. Right here. I'm going to trim it flat so the eye will show through. I'm doing the other side. See the eye right there? I'm going to trim it flat so the eye shows through. Trim a little behind the eye, a little bit more on top. I want to make it pretty uniform. Now I'm going to go up here. I'm going to trim even, make the back of the head even. This side as well, make it even. If you want to get rid of some of the collar below, you can do that or leave it. It's up to you. I'm going to do the more here. A little bit more here. Let me see what I got here. Here, that looks pretty good. That was pretty good. What do you think? There it is. You can trim more, you can trim a needle, you can trim any size you want, or shape, and size. I'm going to trim just a little bit here, cut the, you really want this to, you want that gap, you need some gap bite on here. So, let's take a look at what we've got here. I've got a mess, throw it in the garbage, put it back up here in the vise. And what we've got, there's the NK stream. There goes my little mutt. See it? On that note, I'll let you go. The NK streamer. Enjoy.
An eerie sight, for my monster from his slab began to rise. And suddenly, to my surprise,
he did the mash.
He did the monster mash.
The monster mash.
It was a graveyard smash.
He did the mash.
It caught on in a flash.
He did the mash.
He did the monster mash. From my laboratory in the castle east to the master bedroom where the vampires feast, the ghouls all came from the